bit about learning communities. So as everyone is aware, we ask all first-year students to live in our communities. And we're asking that all first-year students engage in a learning community. So your students have already received their learning community assignment based on their preferences and their application. And so I just want to talk about learning communities a little bit more and why they're so important. We have quite a few, and I'm going to go into the different types of learning communities, but I would like everyone to know learning communities is an opportunity to connect, to already have a group of students, friends, peers that have similar interests. It's also an opportunity for students to grow inside and outside the classroom. So that's really why we're promoting learning communities, and there are three different types of learning communities. There's interest-based, academic-based, and identity-based. And we pretty much have a learning community for every college here. So School of Education, Visual Performing Arts, Business. I won't list out all of them because they're listed here, but I do want to highlight some of the very popular learning communities that are here, as well as our interest-based ones, such as Recreation and Outdoors, Environmental Sustainability, just to name a few. Definitely want to highlight just one more time some of the interest-based LCs. Our academic ones, and I do want to acknowledge that Honors College is also on there, School of Nursing, School of Kinesiology, Health and Human Services, to name some of them additional ones. And we do have one identity-based learning community, which is our LGBTQ plus community. That is for our first-year students as well as our upper-level learning community.
All right, communication. So for this slide, for our presentation for you all as parents and family, we're going to pretend it doesn't say you and it says your student. Because at this point moving forward, as we have the last few weeks and months, we're going to communicate directly with your students, predominantly through their Mason student email accounts. So we'll tell students again tonight when we meet with them. If they aren't in the habit of checking it on a daily basis, they should start immediately. That's the number one way that we, their academic college, their faculty, everyone else in the institution will primarily communicate with them moving forward. So it's super important that they do that. Of course, once they get here, working with our team, our resident site team, our community directors, our RAs are a huge source of information, what's happening on campus, what events they should consider going to, how they find things on campus, how they use their meal plan, et cetera, et cetera. Our website we update often, so if you and your student have other questions, it's always a good place to start first, is go through there, go through our FAQs or different resources, to see if we're already answering your questions in advance. And of course, there's many other ways, bulletin boards in all of our halls, newsletters, Facebook, Instagram. The whole point of this is we do our absolute best every year to think about what are those questions we know students always ask in October, always ask in January, questions parents had in March, and try to proactively address them. If there are things we don't answer, or if we miss or forget, please reach out to us. We do have our main office open Monday through Friday. We do have a 24-hour desk year-round for students for anything as small as question about a lockout or how to put a work order into really serious concerns they have. Part of that staffing model we just discussed is a true 24/7, 365 model where there's literally always someone available to help folks out.
So we often get this question. Our students like to know, who am I living with and where am I living? So that's usually a big one during this time of year. So I wanted to highlight these two important dates. The first one being roommate selection, meaning how they're pairing and partnering with each other to determine who they want to live with. That process is happening right now as we speak. Your students have had the ability to log into their Mason Housing portal and connect with other students and say, hey, are you interested in living together, learning about one another, and engaging in this process for all of June? So it does end on June 30th. So if your student has not logged into the Mason Housing portal, I would absolutely encourage them to do so. That's also where the hub of their housing assignment information will live and continue to live as they continue to progress with us. The second big date is, when are the assignments available? Yes. So we know that that is equally important. So at this point in time, your student may know potentially who their roommate is if they've done some grouping and connecting with other students. And based on their LC, they may know their building, but they don't know the exact location yet, and that information is forthcoming next month, in just a few weeks. And they're gonna get an email about this too. So absolutely, continue to check their email. also encourage them, if they're getting an email, also log into the portal, because their Mason Housing portal also will display at by July 9th at the latest who they're living with and the literal physical location, meaning building and room number.